come from the beginning of the film. My name is Ben Marks, and I would like to welcome you, as I am the first one to present on this project. The thoughts of this project came from me. I did most of the research, so therefore I'm giving myself most of the credit. No offense, Andrew.
None taken.
Thank you. Anyway, the project surrounds one of my favorite figures, and it should be yours too. The Amazing Spider-Man, issue number 121, The Death of Gwen Stacy. As some of you may or may not know, Gwen Stacy was the first love of Peter Parker, a.k.a. Spider-Man, but she met her match when she was killed by the Green Goblin in 1973, issue number 121, where she was tossed off the highest tower of the Brooklyn Bridge in New York. Spider-Man apparently supposedly saved her from sudden impact upon the ground slash water, whatever lied beneath at that apparent time. But for whatever reason, it still remains a mystery today, Gwen Stacy was dead. Physics is related into this as physics is related unto everything else. For the purpose of this project, we decided to use the scene portrayed in the original Spider-Man film directed by Sam Raimi. And the next scene after that is shown from Spider-Man 2, which also describes physics upon stopping a moving train. Thank you.
For the purpose of this project, we used Spider-Man 1 and 2, who was directed by Sam Raimi and released by Columbia Pictures. Now, as most of you know, Spider-Man is played by Tobey Maguire, and MJ is played by Kirsten Dunst. Now, for this project, we personally used a couple scenes. Such scenes were from Spider-Man 1, as in the bridge scene, where MJ was taken on top of the tower with the Green Goblin, and Spider-Man had a choice of saving her or saving the kids and the trolley. And, of course, we know he saved them both. And the second scene we used in Spider-Man 2, which was we used the train scene where he had to stop the train before it went over the edge of the tracks into the water. Now, we're using momentum for this project, so we calculated the amount of force Spider-Man needed to stop that train. And it's just, it's not, definitely not a real-life scenario, but it could happen.
We are who we choose to be. have a train to catch.
Action!
Alright, for the purpose of this project, we use Spider-Man's 1 and 2, who was directed by Sam Raimi and was released by Columbian Pictures. Now, as you
wait... Columbian Pictures?
Andrew seen Take 2?
For this project, we use Spider-Man's 1 and 2, who was directed by Sam Raimi and released by Columbia Pictures. Now, as you wait... I can't get the words out of my mouth.
Cut.
Rush Hour 2.
Take 3. Ben 1. Take 1.
Hello, all. For the purpose of this project, we happen to discover some very interesting information from our best friend, Google. Me being a movie buff, I went on the net looking for physics surrounded any type of superhero. Of course, I found something one of my favorites, The Amazing Spider-Man. Interestingly enough, there has been some physics work done around the topic of Spider-Man, who was created by Stan Lee and...
A person to be named later.
Yes, a person who will be named later. Got it.
Take 5, action!
Alright, for the purpose of this project, we use Spider-Man's 1 and 2, directed by Sam Raimi, and released by Columbia Pictures. Now, as you very...
No! He made me laugh! Stop it!
Benzene Tank 7.
Wilson! No! Wilson! Wilson!
Dramatic for today. That's a wrap, people. Somebody get me.
Oh, thank God.
Johnson, where's my coffee? And I want my.
Where's my donkey?
Where's my donkey? Where's my donkey? Give me my donkey! Back!
That was a close one.
Overload. And he loved donkey. Donkey loved daddy?
Oh.
What are you still doing here?
Get out! Get out now!
That's it. I'm shutting you down.